Hi guys, so today we're going to finally take a look at it, how to import the data we scanned with the iPhone 12 Pro to Business Center. So I have exported few files from the iPhone and saved them to my cloud and pulled them off for you. Here are the formats you can export from the app. So LAS, point cloud, the same thing as XYZ, it's pretty much the same. And then I have something for CSV, which is already processed through the business center, exported as a CAT files, and then we'll bring it back in. So we'll go through that process here. Easy as taking LAS, dragging and dropping it into business center. It's asking us, what unit file it is. It's in meters because when I was exporting it was asking me, so I put it in meters. I hit okay, and it's asking us whether these are non-georeference ground scale point cloud or georeference scaled point cloud. So we'll try both of them. Right now I'm just gonna go non-reference. And you know, after a few seconds, it brings in the point cloud. We can take a quick peek here on the left hand side, pile test, and hit properties and see what we have in there. Actually under scans, that's what I was wanting to, right? So here actually under scans and scan Y1, it's telling us that within that 4 minutes and 18 seconds or whatever it took us to scan this pile, it took 191,000 points. If we want to take a quick peek at it, I'm going to jump into a 3D view here and you guys going to see, right? You guys gonna see this pile. Also here is like a little option where you can make the points thicker, so it would kind of make it more joined together. If you go extra large, it's just gonna give you, obviously, as you guys can see, when I did this, you know, I have few holes. However, depending on the shape of the pile, we're talking a minuscule hole, which is gonna not gonna affect our volume. So as far as we can see, you know, this is a nice pile. I do not have a point cloud module, so if I want to do some stuff, obviously it's not gonna let me. There is few little tits and bits which you can do. So one nice thing which Business Center lets you do is create CAT points out of this. So if you're not familiar with the point cloud, you know, you can just hit this create CAT points from scan point. There is few settings, you know, spatial select, I'm gonna select our point cloud. Spacing 0.1, so which layer you want to put it in. Once you hit OK, Business Center is actually creating a whole bunch of, I don't know if you guys can see this here, let me do like that. You see those little cut points? Now what you can do is you can go to your layer manager. I can turn everything off, even the scan, and I can turn on, I put it, I believe, so I have, I put it on layer zero. So this is my pile. Now, when I have it with a cat, I can start creating surface out of it and layout and get some volumes. So as you guys can see, I took my CAT points and I created a nice surface. And as I was talking about these holes kind of went triangulate across, if you look at it, this is a small pile. So the distance is, you know, half a meter between points. I mean, if you were to topple this pile, you wouldn't have as much detail as you have here anyway. So pretty nice. Once you have the surface, you can go to your surfaces and earthworks report and just do a stockpile. I called it a pile test lidar scan. Obviously spelling is not the best. Let's see, here it is. So we have about 4 cubic meters, obviously I'm working metric, 4 cubic meters of topsoil in that pile, which I'm gonna have to shovel and move with the wheelbarrow to our flower beds. Nonetheless, quick and easy. Is that about right for the volume? I mean, it was about half a truck of topsoil. The truck is usually 9-10 cubes, depending on how full it was. So I would say pretty accurate. I'm gonna run some more tests in the near future and see how close I get with the actual, you know, survey the pile with the GPS or toll station and do it this way and see how it compares. I hope you enjoyed this series of videos. Subscribe and hit the bell. We're gonna have some other apps and some other descriptions, and we're gonna test this out as we go here in the near future. Thanks for watching.